let's go right.
Hello, good morning. It is currently 8:25, more or less. It is, I think, 15 degrees. Slightly clouded, but should get better later on today. And today we're going to Harley-Davidson, the Truck Experience Tour. So, Demo Dave from Harley-Davidson. I'm going there together with Luke, the guy I'm riding with already for 12 years. And we're just gonna ride some Harley-Davidsons. Have some fun. The Harley-Davidsons that I'm gonna ride are gonna be the Lightwire and the Pan America. What else? Now, I also really would have liked to ride a sport glide or a road glide or something like that, but unfortunately there were just two spots available, but there was something went wrong with the listing, so more luck next time. But I'm really looking forward to both of these bikes. That's fun. I've just recently installed a quick shift. I put the video up here. That's good fun, I can tell you. Yeah, but I'm really looking forward to the Pan America to see what Harley Davidson actually made out of the all-road. So, really, really looking forward to that. And what I've seen online is that actually people are quite positive about it. So maybe it's not fair because the first all-road that Harley made, but I actually have quite some high expectations for the bike. You know, I at least expect to have a lot of fun on it. And then the Lightwire is going to be the first electric bike I'm going to ride, and I have absolutely no clue how that's going to be. But the tour is in Heteren, so that's going to be an hour 15 minutes for us, more or less. First going to get some gas, get some coffee with the... What the... Okay. So, as I was saying, fuel, coffee, then we go. I just noticed that the Red Ryder is leaking a little bit of fuel. One of the fuel lines, there's a pinch hole in it. So luckily, my dad doesn't use a V-Strom today. So I'm gonna pick up the V-Strom now and hope that we still make it more or less in time. We'll see. And I already doubted this year whether I should replace the fuel lines, because they didn't really look really nice anymore. Okay, you can imagine that's the case after 20 plus years, but... The stupid thing is, it's just... This much is actually fuel line, the rest is all tubing. And that's, you know, 10 centimeters of fuel line actually leaking. So, I'm not sure if you can see it. So actually, right there, it's a tiny pinch hole. I can probably just connect this, the quick disconnect there, but I'll fix that after I'm back. Picked up the V-Strom, but now we're running a little bit late. That's a bit unfortunate. But I guess, well, I know for quite sure that would have been late anyway. Us knowing us. Eh? So, and I couldn't find the navigation so quick. So I don't have any navigation. I do have my, if the cockpit cam is in the top box. Oh. Almost at Harley Davidson, big river in Heteren, but it's already 10:35, so the guys probably already left for the group ride. But at least we're in time for the next one. And maybe then the fog clears up as well, so you can actually see a little bit of the landscape and the surroundings instead of just a lot of white mist. Oh, just see. Effortless. Heb jij hem al vol open getrokken?
Nee, maar ik probeer telkens wel stukjes uit te kiezen na een bocht dat ik hem even laat lopen en dan vol open trekken. Maar dat dat geeft zoveel power.
Dit ding is echt zo bruut. Ik heb hem nog niet eens helemaal open gehad, maar het gaat echt zo verschrikkelijk hard.
Maar wel een lekker geluidje ook hoor. Ja, hij trilt wel.
Dit is ja. Harley, hè?
Wat wil je?
One of the bikes I rode at the GS tour was the it was the Urban GS, which is more or less the scrambler. I think it compares more or less with the Livewire in terms of geometry. I do think the Livewire is way more fun than the RT, and it's solely down to the acceleration, because I think the Urban GS is probably more agile. But you know, if it's not my primary bike, I would definitely pick the Livewire over the Urban GS. But I'm really impressed with the bike. And it's a lot of fun to ride. I can't help it. Back on the shoes definitely feels different. Feels a bit lighter than the Harleys I've just been riding. But I had a lot of fun nevertheless, so... Unfortunately, I couldn't get the cockpit came to work because I left a rubber mount on my GS in at my parents' house. So that stinks. We got about an hour left back to ride back home. And then I'm gonna try to visit the motorcycle shop to see if I can get a piece of hose that's to replace the leaking part. So that's it for today. I will see you the next time. Bye.